Some might strive to become the PPM god. Well, in this series, we're gonna see how we can turn you into the ultimate skill. Alright, you just saw that intro. You know how much work that just took? It doesn't matter. You saw that intro, you should have already subscribed. If you haven't subscribed, watch the rest of the video and subscribe after that. Anyway, subscribe. To kick the series off, we're going to be taking a look at the crystal fishing rod. Now, in order to work towards this, you will need to have Prif unlocked, which takes us into the first part of this episode, is the base minimum requirements for your player. Now, for Prif, you're going to need to have a majority of your stats at level 75, but to unlock the crystal fishing rod, you are also going to require level 90 agility, 90 range, 90 strength, and 93 fishing. If you're like me and have not done many quests, because questing is about the equivalent of stabbing yourself in the eye with a ice pick while watching your space bar scream in pain, it's good to understand to unlock Prif, it is roughly around 5 hours of quests. On screen, you can see the list of quests that you have to complete with times that I've taken from tutorials on YouTube to get a good approximation for how long it may take you to complete each one. So if you are interested in this, and this is something that you're going to want to go for, this will hopefully give you an idea of what you're going to be taking on. So great, you've decided that the crystal fishing rod is something that you want to obtain. Now, once you go to Prif, you are going to want to run north, and then you are going to want to take the second right, and this will take you over to the fishing spot. You will need a grappling hook and a crossbow. You can see on screen me running over to it and climbing it. At this point, you can see where you're going to need that grappling hook to get up to these spots. This is where the 90 agility, 90 range, and 90 strength come into play. And again, there are three spots on top of this. Once you get up there, it's level 93, level 95, and level 97 fishing for each one of these spots. These do correspond to the size of crystal urchins that you can obtain. And in order to create the crystal fishing rod, you must unlock the ability to craft it with 3,000 crystal urchin points. The different size urchins do provide different levels of points. So again, depending on your level, here's a breakdown. You're going to need to catch about 3,000 small crystal urchins, 1,500 medium crystal urchins, or 1,000 large crystal urchins at level 97. So depending on your fishing level and when you want to obtain this, it does get easier the higher level you are. However, getting 3,000 of the small urchins honestly does not take that long. There are a couple events that happen when you're up on this waterfall that can help you boost and gain more points than just catching them by themselves. So again, not a terrible thing, but you will need to do this first before creating the rod. The reason you're going to want to go for this is for its 5% increased chance of success rates while fishing. And this rod also stacks with the Perfect Juju Fishing Potion as well as the Fury Shark outfit. With our benefits out the way, we're going to take a look at the two types of rods that you can obtain. First is the standard crystal rod. This will last 1,000 charges while you're within Prif, or 500 charges outside of Prif. Reversely, you can also augment the crystal rod, which then begins to use your divine charges and will not degrade to dust. Personally, I would say the augmented rod is the most preferred method to go forward here. So to understand what it's gonna take, you do have to have the fishing rod-o-matic discovered, which does require level 22 invention. And this tool acts as a level 70 invention tool. So that's gonna help us determine the amount of XP you're gonna gain from siphoning. And I would say it's best to siphon this with a standard equipment siphon and not the crystal tool siphon, because it is quite expensive. And it does actually require a higher level of invention of 54 to be able to discover your crystal tool siphon as well. Now, it is important to understand where this rod is going to work and not work for you as you make this decision. This rod will work anywhere that a fishing rod, fly fishing rod, or heavy rod is used for a fishing spot, and it will also work at the swarm spot in the deep sea fishing hub, which I think is the majority of where people will be using this to AFK fishing to higher levels. Now, adversely, pretty straightforward on where this rod does not work. However, one area that is worth calling out is going to be creosis. This rod does not work at the skilling nodes or within the boss. So if you're going to use anything for that to help on that boss fight, unfortunately, the crystal rod will not be able to support you in that. This is going to be really kind of a tool to help you if fishing is a moneymaker for you. Maybe you're going for fishvention to get your invention levels up, or again, you're going for 120 or higher in fishing. Now, going back into why you should be able to use a normal siphon versus the crystal siphon is going to be the cost. So I gave a breakdown on the screen to really show you the difference here is a normal siphon, as this tool acts as a tier 70 tool, you're going to get 459,000 experience at level 12. Utilizing a crystal tool siphon acts as a tier 90 tool while siphoning. You're going to gain 621,000 experience, but at a greater cost. So cost per XP for the normal siphon is about 25 cents, or versus the other side, which is about 1.97 GP. So it is pretty significant. However, if you want to go ahead and get your invention up faster and cost is not a factor, I wanted to give that option for you. Now, to create the rod, you have two options. The first requires talking to an NPC, and it does require you to bring some GP with you. The other way is the singing bowl, which does require a crystal tool seed as well. However, it's going to cost you 150 harmonic dust. So keep that in mind as you go forward. I do recommend just bringing some GP, buying the crystal tool seed off the Grand Exchange. And in the video here, you can see me going to exchange my seed. So what you're gonna wanna do is teleport into Prif, run west, and then you're gonna wanna click and hit use on the crystal tool seed. Click on the NPC, it'll pop up the options, and you can choose what type of crystal tool you'll want. In this case, again, you are going to want to select the crystal rod at the bottom. If this is the first time you're making it, it's going to cost you just above 500 GP to do so. So keep that in mind. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, please like, comment, and subscribe. Again, continue to play the game the way you want to play. I'll see you out there in Gilanor. Peace.